In this lesson, I want you to think about computations that, on the surface, don't appear to have any parallelism. In the process, you'll learn what I think are some really neat tricks about how to extract parallelism when it's not obvious how to do so. As a teaser, I want you to imagine the following scenario. Suppose you're standing in an absurdly long line in a very large room. The room is completely dark, so you can't see anything. Maybe you're waiting in line at the registrar's office to pick up your OMSCS degree. You ask yourself, how many people are in front of me in this line? And to find out, you can only talk to the person right in front of you or right behind you. That's not so hard, you say. After all, you're young, smug, and smart. And you know that the first person knows that she's the first person. So she can turn to her neighbor behind her and say, hey, I'm number one. That person now knows that he must be number two. So he pays it forward, or in this case backwards, and tells his position to the next person, and it goes on and on like this. Now that's a lovely and simple solution to this problem. But suppose there are 10 million people in this line. If it takes 1 second to do an information exchange, then it's going to take about 10 million people times 1 second divided by 3,600 seconds per hour divided by 24 hours per day, or 115 days for the last person in line to learn that he or she is number 10 million. That person in nearly 4 months' time could have probably finished a whole other OMSCS degree. Now, this scenario is an analogy for a well-known problem in parallel algorithms called list ranking. You are given a singly linked list and a pointer to the head. What you want to compute is the position of every node in the list. Sequentially, it's trivial to do, but if you have multiple processors, can you use parallelism to do it faster? You might want to pause the video for a second and see if you can think of a way. And unless you already know how, I bet you'll have a very hard time doing so. To get an efficient parallel scheme, what you might find is that everything you've been told about the best way to store a linked list is completely wrong. File it under lies my other teachers told me. So, without further ado, let's see if we can undo a couple years of bad sequential computing habits.